Hi, I'm Letitia SD, and you're watching the Weekly Hip Hop Newscast. Lil Wayne, Cash Money Records, and Universal are all being sued for $1 million US in relation to an incident at Morgan State University concert last October. A 17-year-old young lady is claiming injury after being trampled by the mini riot that was caused when Wayne threw money into the crowd. Complaining of memory loss and headaches, if successful, there may well be a few more 17-year-olds with headaches chasing more than dollar bills. Last Sunday, the Wu-Tang Rock the Bells tour in Chicago came to a halt when Method Man responded to chants of "Puff Wu-Tang" by one guy in the front row. As the Wu huddled around Meth, he questioned the guy's chants when Streetlife jumped off stage and apparently punched the guy in the face. Another concert with Nas on the bill has been under threat due to Nas's apparent violent lyrics. Organised by a student group, the Rock the Vote concert was scheduled to take place at Ottawa Congress Centre on October the 1st in Canada. The event was to encourage concertgoers to vote on the elections in Ontario, but the venue have apparently enforced their blanket ban on hip-hop acts, insisting Nas's lyrics promote gun violence. The organisers are currently looking for an alternative venue. Even though it leaked weeks before being released, Talib Kweli's sixth album, Eardrum, debuted at number 2 in the Billboard charts last week and looks destined to be a classic. Often labelled as a conscious rapper, his new album sold 60,000 units in its first week. If you're at a uni in the US, Talib is letting his fans demand which 5 campuses he performs at on eventful.com/Talib Kweli. In Mansfield, Louisiana, a law has passed that bans the wearing of your clothes in a manner which exposes your underwear. From September the 15th, people of Mansfield face a $150 fine and possible jail time. Basically, the police are targeting what they call the hip-hop or thug style of dressing, where your belt's hugging your thighs. It's a good thing we don't film this in Louisiana. We thought we'd try something different this week. We're bringing you the news in one-line snippets. We're calling it Bang It Out. If you've got any ideas for a better name, you can contact news@jumpoff.tv. Lil Kim was pulled over by police for driving without number plates. Q-Tip and Common are forming a group called The Standard. Mims claims Kanye stole his sped-up soul sample style. Maybe she'd be pissed at LL first. The Game and Timbaland have been sued by an Indian company for the music used in Put You on the Game. And Atlanta broke the Guinness World Record for line dancing with 17,000 people doing the Cupid Shuffle. That was this week's Bang It Out news section. For those of you who watched last week's newscast, here are the updates. A judge denies Foxy Brown an early release while New York's Rikers Island prison wardens are keeping her in isolation for security reasons. Maybe Foxy would have had a better chance of an early release if her daddy owned a chain of hotels. The white powder found at DMX's Arizona home during last week's raid was not drugs. Rough Riders CEO Darren D. Dean was indicted on Wednesday on drugs and weapon charges. He and his driver may face up to 20 years in prison. Last week, Sean Kingston announced on the Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards that he had nailed the part of Biggie in the forthcoming movie. Contrary to almost every news source reporting this, the casting role to play Biggie is still open. Former manager and executive producer of the flick, Wayne Barrows, did audition Sean but says they are still looking. The 9/11 SoundScan showdown is under 2 weeks away and both Curtis and Graduation leaked last week. First Graduation spread through the digital world into reality, then the next day, almost like an act of revenge or a publicity stunt, Curtis followed. A little suspect, we think. After he stormed the stage at Screamfest unexpectedly last week on Kanye's track, 50 has reignited beef talk saying, "It's the teddy bear versus the gorilla. Kanye sucks. He sounds like a robot." Misinfo has the exclusive 50 Cent version of the forthcoming Rolling Stone cover. And finally, the 6th annual Hip Hop Kemp Festival took place in Bohemia, Czech Republic last weekend. The massive 3-day event takes place every August and is one of the biggest hip hop festivals in Europe, attended by almost 20,000 fans. Last weekend's fans saw over 60 live acts and DJs including Redman, MOP, Dilated Peoples, EMC and Faith SFX from England, plus 8 b-boy crews including the 2006 Battle of the Year champions, Vagabonds. You can keep up to date daily with all the news and gossip on jumpoff.tv. Please leave comments below or on /newscast. If you have comments just for me, go to jumpoff.tv/LetitiaSD. I'm Letitia SD, and that was this week's newscast. If successful, there may well be a more few 17-year-olds. Cash. Blah, blah, blah. Wayne threw money into the crowd. I'm still fucking up. I am trying to focus. You lot shouldn't be running jokes. This is a place of work. Right. Take place at Ottawa Congress Centre on October 1st in Canada. Ottawa, Ottawa. You lot are wasting my serotonin. Even though it leaked weeks before being released. Even though it leaked weeks before being released. Sorry. His sixth album, Eardrum, debuted. That made no sense. Sixth album, Eardrum, where your belt's hugging your thighs. Thighs? Thighs. Yeah, you should cuff me. Face £150,000 fine. Dollar. Wow. We're trying something new this week. Sorry. Oh, don't. Contact news at jumpoff.tv. First graduation spread through the digital world. We're gonna... And finally, the sixth annual hip-hop festival. For those of you who watched last week's newscast, here are the...